Hello everyone, this is Geert, and this is Sirius Sam, the second encounter. And we are in the City of the Gods, picking up a whole bunch of ammo, and going to the little overview. Now this level is a bit of a mess, to be perfectly honest. There's a lot of enemy spawns, which are kind of easy to miss in this level. Which, you know, isn't really a problem, it's just very possible that you'll walk across a path which you probably walked along before, and then it just spawns some more stuff, which you could also avoid by just taking a different path altogether, and some of this will become a lot more noticeable as we move along, but we'll be looking at a statue of Montezuma, and a Tommy gun, and a bunch of ammo, which we can use for both our minigun and our Tommy gun as well, and a statue of some snakes with some doors, and our final destination here, really.
Wait for me, Montezuma. Here I come.
Now I'm going to start off the level by going left. You can actually go right as well, because it's just one big square. And I'm just going to ignore most of these sounds while I walk backwards and go to get some secret cannonballs, which we can't actually use yet, but we'll get around there eventually. Eventually we'll be able to use some cannonballs. For now, just make sure that you try not to get hit by too many of these rockets, and instead just take care of the enemies that are shooting the rockets, while also taking care of the peeps who are shooting you from greater distances. I'm gonna shoot that one with a minigun. That's a new type of enemy. It is the commander version of those guys, so you can as well just hit them with a flamethrower and they'll just be stuck for a while, but I like to take care of them as quickly as possible because they shoot 5 bullets and they actually deal a little bit more damage than the normal ones as well. Or at least it seems like they do. Now, when we pick up this Tommy gun, it's gonna spawn a bunch of stuff. And all of it's rather nasty, and I'm going to run to this specific corner over here because I find it a little bit easier to take care of the enemies here compared to really any other location in this place. There is one location where it's even more easy, but that is like so silly, it's a bit cheap really. There's a bunch of kamikazes, and more importantly, there's a bunch of these guys, like the harpies are spawning as well. And the combination of these two enemies is, it can be a bit terrifying, as you can probably imagine. Because when the harpies get close, they get really, really annoying. And sitting in this corner makes everything a little bit more safe, just due to the fact that there is no exit from here. Everything is running into you. So you've pretty much got full control of the situation just because everything dies so quickly. And because things can't sneak up on you either. So it's just, I find it a little bit more safe. It is a bit scary when the harpies get close to you. And even if things start to go wrong, you can break this wall. And there's a secret armor behind it. So just going to pick that up now because I think we've taken care of pretty much everything here. Now, we saw a big statue of Montezuma. Montezuma being the dude that often judged prisoners by using either a scary mask or a happy mask, and if you were given the scary mask, you were probably gonna die, and if you were given the happy mask, then you were probably gonna live. And we have to get those two masks and bring them to the statue, which is over there. And the first mask is over here. It doesn't really matter in which order you get the masks, but some enemies only spawn after you've picked up one of the masks, and some enemies only spawn when you've picked up both of them. And I find that the enemy spawns are a bit easier to take care of, or at least a bit easier to see when you get this mask first. So we're just gonna go over here first. And the first mask is inside this room. It's guarded by a bunch of these things that shoot spikes, but they barely do any damage, so I'm not really gonna worry about it, really. And that's the first mask. It's the hilariously happy mask, and it does sound hilariously happy. Also, zoom in at this door, because there's a dude with the chainsaw waiting for us, and he can be a bit nasty if you're not prepared. Fortunately, he died rather quickly, as do these guys, and let's grab the ammo as well. And there's another armor up here if you want it, but since we're at 100-100 anyway, I'm not really concerned. Of course, then we take falling damage, but whatever, I'm not really bothered. And there's also a 100 health pickup over here, which is guarded by 2 bills. One of which is over there, which was invisible, but it is definitely over there. And also, more importantly, it has that guy who's going to shoot rockets at us if we go around the corner. And rockets really, really hurt. So preferably I don't do that, and instead just kill him over here. And I don't think I'm going to bother with that armor, really. We should be fine. Now that we've picked up the first mask, though, it spawned a bunch of enemies, which are just kind of all over the place. One is over there, and one is over there, and one is over there. And the minigun people just kind of hurt a lot. Well, the thing is, like, they don't really hurt a lot, but if you don't take care of them, they do really small amounts of damage a lot of the time, and eventually it just starts to add up if you don't take care of them quickly. And if you get close to them, they generally just hit a lot more than otherwise, so it is a good idea to just take care of them as quickly as possible. Now, we put the first mask in. We don't really need to do that until we get both masks, really, but I just like doing it because it makes the cutscene that's coming up a bit cooler. And there's a tree here, which we can break with our chainsaw, and shows us some secret health. And this is actually kind of hard to get in multiplayer, because I think in this version, in the multiplayer, you can't actually break things. So you pretty much forced to just rocket jump on this wall and then go past it, if that's even possible. But we don't have to worry about that, because we're playing single player. So that's an enemy, which is one of those spawn triggers which I was talking about earlier, which is just, it's easy to avoid by just walking all the way around, but I don't really want to because I'm lazy. And this is just a bit faster, really, and I think there should be one more. I'm just going to kill it with a rocket, because I feel like it makes the trees fall down a bit and looks cool. And on our way to the next mask, which is over there. And there is, next to that mask, there's actually a bunch of secret areas as well, which are really going to benefit us during this level. They have some really cool stuff in it. But more importantly, there is two guys here, one of which has a minigun. And one of which has a minigun. And that one's not very smart, because it forgets that it has a gun on its arm. And then it can't fire at us, so it just sort of sits there. And there's also two headless kamikazes behind those two walls, but as you can see there, they explode quite well. Now this is breakable, and it takes us to a secret corridor. I think you need a rocket, but there's a bunch of rockets lying there if you've run out of rockets, so should be good. And inside that secret is another secret, because you can break that thing as well, and it has a secret cannon in it, which is the weapon which fires the strongest projectiles in the game. It can take care of the red biomechanoids in a single shot as long as you charge it. Like, you have to hold the fire button for a while, and the more you hold it, the stronger and faster and further the cannonball is going to go. And we'll be using that weapon quite a lot. Not just quite yet, but later on in the level, it's going to make some prominent appearances, as you will be able to see. I'm just going to grab these as well, I think. Yeah, that should be good. Because the second mask is on our way over here. And I'm just going to hold the flamethrower ready, because we're going to have to burn some things in a second after picking up this mask. And there's a whole bunch of people running around outside. I'm not really sure why they're walking in circles, but, you know, they've got to do something with their spare time, I guess. And the main reason I put the mask in there is because it makes its eyes all shiny. Now hold backwards when you're here, because it's going to spawn a bunch of frogs over there, and it's kind of scary. And I'm going to sit in this corner specifically, because it spawns a bunch of clear skeletons, which are all going to try to hit us with projectiles, and it's all a bit nasty, but they're all coming from the wall on the other side. And I'm going to burn these two bulls so I can see them, because they're invisible half the time, and it's kind of scary. But if you set them on fire, they become a lot less scary, because they're not really invisible anymore. Because when you set a bull on fire, it pretty much has fire all over its body. And if you lose a lot of health, you can always just pick up that health power up over there and you should be good. Fortunately, we didn't take too much damage, so we really don't have much to worry about. Except for the guys who are waiting for us, which is these two, and then there's one over there. And they can be pretty scary, you know, if you're not prepared. But we should be good. I love that sound so much. It's great. It's a shame they made those enemies have a different sound effect in the HD remake. Doesn't make them sound quite as annoying. Anyway, picking up the second mask spawns those guys, and having two masks in general makes this guy spawn. And that guy's really annoying if you're not ready for it. And it's also pretty much the main reason why I pick up this mask second, because you end up right in front of him. And I think there's another one just sitting on top of the building or something. Yeah. But if you pick up the other mask second, then you're over there. And it's very easy to not see that there is an enemy all the way over here when you continue onwards and go through the door. Because you will be over there. And when we go there, after we put both masks in there, it'll spawn a bunch of enemies. And it's just a bit nasty, really. And when you're taking care of those enemies, it's very easy to get shot by a guy that's over there. So it's best to just get that mask second and then just take care of it immediately. Now, there is a serious bomb here. For some reason, it doesn't count as a secret area. But fortunately, to make us feel better, this little thingy does. And this is why we picked up the cannon, because this bloodbath is kind of scary to take care of without the cannon. Because you have to shoot 5 missiles otherwise per guy, and that's 15 missiles we have to use, and there's a good chance the second one will spawn before the first one is dead, and it's just a bit of a mess, really, but killing them like this makes it a lot more manageable, and it gives us a lot less to worry about. Now, I just remembered that I talked earlier about when you pick up the Tommy gun, there is another place where you can stand, but it just feels a bit too cheesy. And that's actually on the pyramid. It's a very strict timing, but if you press the jump button, pretty much the moment you hit the slope, you can jump on top of the pyramid. The main downside with this is that the harpies spawn over there, so you have to take care of them pretty much as they spawn. But the upside of it is that kamikazes can't jump up here. So you'll just be safe from every single kamikaze that tries to get on your, that tries to kill you, basically. And yeah, you can climb as high as you want, but preferably you'll just get on top of like the first floor and then you just shoot everyone from there, because, well, from the first floor you can take care of all the harpies, and then the kamikazes, well, they just sit there, they just run into a wall and scream a lot, so it's not really scary. Anyway, we slide down and we move forward and put in the second mask, which opens the door to the next area. Both masks are placed on the altar. Plays a little cutscene which shows us something which really isn't all that useful, because we've already seen that we have to go to this door in the previous cutscene, but, well, not really the previous cutscene, but the first cutscene we saw when we entered this level. But in case you forgot, that's the door where we have to go to. Now, as we move closer to the door, it's going to spawn two guys, and those two guys are, they're not friends. We're gonna have to take care of them, but fortunately we have a lot of rockets and they just sort of sit there and try to shoot at you, so as long as you avoid their missiles and shoot missiles at their face, should be good. You can use the cannon here if you want, but the thing is, we're not getting quite as much cannonball ammo as we're... cannonball ammo. We're not getting as much, many cannonballs as we're getting missiles, so I prefer to just take care of them with rockets, really, because I like to use the cannonballs for a rainy day. Because you can carry around 50 missiles and 30 cannonballs, and there's not as many, and, you know, it's... might as well use them. Anyway, I'm just going to quickly check that I have 6 secrets right now, and I do, which is good. If I didn't, then I missed one, and I wouldn't know which one I missed, so that would be a problem, but we're on schedule. There's a bunch of enemies here, and there's a bunch of statues here. And now that I actually remember, if you're playing the HD remake, you're gonna actually want to destroy these snake heads as well. Like, there are 4 of those snake statues in this level, and in the HD remake, there is a secret area that requires you to break all of them. The thing is, it doesn't really indicate it when you shoot the first one, it only just says secret area after you shoot the 4th one. So it's very easy to miss, but just shoot it from here or from the other side or from wherever, really. The moment it gets inside your view, it's time to kill it. You can also break all these things if you want, but it doesn't really do anything except for breaking things. Now, there's more of these spikes here. Again, they don't really deal that much damage, so they're not much to worry about. That guy, however, can be a bit of a nuisance, so just get rid of him as quickly as possible. And honestly, I'm not even going to really try to dodge these things. I'm just going to try to jump a bit, but that's about it. Because they just don't really do anything. And there's 2 enemies there, and somehow I managed to kill both of them. And there's also another enemy over there, and he's cool because you can kill him by shooting a grenade into the wall. And it makes you feel a little bit fancy if you manage to bounce a grenade into a wall. Just looks cool, really. And that brings us to the next area, where it plays another little cutscene. There's 2 guys just happily patrolling. And there's 1 guy on the left as well who's just standing still. He's actually completely unable to move because his AI says so. And there's a minigun here, which would be really cool if we didn't already have one. But fortunately, picking up a minigun, even though we already have it, gives us 100 bullets, so that's cool. I think in the HD remake, it actually gives you 200 or something like that, maybe even 150. But I'm gonna shoot that guy. Mostly because he can't see us while we're standing over here. If he would see us while we're standing over here, he would shoot us and immediately end the cutscene, because if you take damage in a cutscene, the cutscene just ends. And these guys are not very good at patrolling, because I just shot them, really. So there's a secret area next to that tree. I'll get it in a second, though. First, we're going to worry about these guys, because when you kill these guys, it immediately spawns a few more kamikazes pretty much right next to them. And they just jump from behind you over there. Not really sure where they came from, but somehow they managed to end up there and jump over that wall. But fortunately, we killed them, and everything's good. Now, I'm going to pick up this and just sort of run around with a flamethrower and start shooting people, because it's fun. And I like burning people. These guys are just oddly amusing to burn to me. And we might as well use some of our flamethrower ammo, because there's a bunch of it lying inside that building, which we're running towards anyway. And every now and then shoot some missiles towards the blue guys, because they die in a single missile. And it takes care of pretty much everyone really quickly. Now again, there is a secret next to that tree. I will go there the moment everything in this place is dead, for reasons which I'll get into later. But for now, you're just gonna have to trust me. Try not to get hit too much here. But honestly, it doesn't really matter too much. As long as you don't die, then it really doesn't matter how much you get hit here. Because there's a lot of health waiting for us. And there's a 50 health power-up over here if things really do get too dicey. But just keep shooting. Just keep firing. It should spawn some of those minigun people soon. There we go, right on schedule. One's over there. I don't remember where the other one is, which is a bit of a problem. It might be over there. Yeah, I hit a tree. The hitboxes on those trees are a bit weird sometimes. You can very clearly miss it and it'll still just hit the tree instead. It's kind of unfortunate, really. Lost kind of a lot of health, but again, it doesn't really matter too much. Just gonna get rid of these guys and get inside this building, because there's a bunch of ammo waiting for us, and that person, and also that person, but mostly ammo. Primarily ammo, and it pretty much fills up everything that we used up here, except for the sniper rifle, which is a bit unfortunate, really. I like my sniper rifle bullets, but we sadly just don't get that much of it. I think you'll probably end up getting more cannonballs in this level than sniper rifle bullets, which is unfortunate. And speaking of cannonball ammo, or just cannonballs, really, I'm not really sure why I keep saying cannonball ammo, but it somehow seems natural to me. There's a secret area over here which has some secret cannonballs. And another snakehead as well. So we're just going to take care of that, because we're pretending to play the HD remake. And we're actually just going to grab our cannon as well, just to use some of our cannonballs immediately, because the moment we get close to that door, spawns that guy. Best to just take care of him immediately, because it also has a bunch of these red dudes, and they can be a bit of a nuisance, really. So taking care of them quickly makes you feel good. And I'm just going to grab this now.
Minigun. For maximum pleasure.
Mostly grab that now, just so you can hear the one-liner very clearly, because otherwise it's kind of muffled because of all the music and stuff. Now I'm actually going to go to the secret area, and I'm actually going to grab this, and that's because it makes life a little bit easier. There's a teleporter over here, and I think there's still one of those red guys alive, but I'll take care of him real afterwards. There's a lot of fish in the water, so don't go in the water just yet. In fact, just run here and then immediately run back again, because there's a bunch of scary stuff over here, which is gigantic clear skeletons. They're really, really big. I don't really know why, but this secret area is pretty cool that way. I really like this secret area because it's just filled with stuff like this, and I really like it. But it should probably start to spawn those guys. And I hit a tree again somehow. Please stop, please. The trees are like the biggest enemies here, because they just block all of your shots very, very well. Are you over there? There you are. There you are. And there's also the green dudes who shoot the green balls of death, and just everything here is really unpleasant because everything's really, really small. And even though they're that small, they still deal the same amount of damage as the big dudes, so they are a force to be reckoned with. Generally, the small types of enemies are just a lot more dangerous than their big counterparts, just because they're that much harder to hit. And this is no exception. And there's another minigun dude somewhere over here. I'm not really sure where, though. probably hiding in there somewhere, but it's really hard to tell in this place. Like, he's shooting the tree, so he has to be somewhere over there. But I can't quite see him. I'm just gonna save the game. Make sure I don't die in a silly way. I want to get into the water in a minute, but... There he is! Jeez. Finally. So, as we get closer, it'll spawn some more stuff. Which is unique to pretty much only this area. Which is frogs. We've never seen those enemies before. They're a bit bigger than other frogs in the game. Marsh hoppers, I guess, if you want to get technical. And these are kind of hilarious because, as you can see, sometimes they jump from that tree and they kill themselves with falling damage. And I just find that oddly amusing. And I kind of don't want to get shot by that fish over there who's making a lot of noise. So I'm kind of hoping that doesn't happen. Just going to take care of these guys. They still have the same amount of health, again, as their small counterparts. They're just really, really big. They don't deal any more damage. They're just big. It's great. Oh, jeez. This is unfortunate. He's hard to see right now. That's one shot. That's one shot. There we go. And there's another one over there. I'm running out of sniper rifle ammo, so I'm just going to shoot him with missiles instead. And there's a whole bunch of green balls flying all over the place right now, and I don't like it. Get out of here. That one exploded by itself, but I pretended to shoot it anyway. Okay, there's a bunch of fish in that water, and there's only grenades, so I don't really care about that just now. There's armor in that one, and that's the one I was looking for. I'm just going to shoot some grenades to the right and hope I'm going to hit anything at all. Probably not, but there's so many grenades here anyway, and we're not really going to use any of them anyway. Let's just shoot a bit. I have a really hard time seeing the fish in the water here. I'm not really sure why. Because they're invisible, for as far as I know, as much as all the other enemies. But for some reason, I always just have a really hard time seeing them, except when I'm underwater. So maybe it's just a combination of water effects with them eventually growing invisible and being visible again. But either way, they're kind of a nuisance. Now, the moment they see you, they'll make that sound. And that usually means they're in the corner right here. And that's something to be careful of. Because when they're in the corner and you stand on top of them, they hurt. When you're standing on top of them when they attack, they will deal a lot of damage. And there's a very good chance you'll just end up flying all the way in that direction. And it's just rather unpleasant, really. Another thing to look out for, which I'll talk about in a second, after taking care of this right here. For some reason he didn't shoot me, but I don't mind. I don't mind if they didn't shoot me. One thing to keep in mind in this place, if you shoot the heads, it actually spawns red biomechanoids. And, that can be a problem. That can be a very serious problem if you're shooting something. And suddenly that guy's over there. Especially since when you go over here and grab these cannonballs, it'll spawn those guys right next to the statue as well. Like, that is just the nastiest spawn point, because there's just such a large chance that you'll accidentally hit a statue with a rocket and just destroy yourself, really. Now, as we move forward, I'm actually going to grab some health over here. I'm skipping that health power-up just now, because of reasons. Really. I just want to have as much health as we leave this place. So, yeah, it starts to spawn these guys. And you may have noticed, you may not have noticed, it's very easy to tell, to not notice it really. These guys are really small. These guys are really, really small. And just like any other small enemy, they deal as much damage as their big counterparts. And this is the problem. Because they're really hard to hit. And they hurt a lot. Like, the headless kamikazes, they only get one attack, but their one attack is good. It's so strong. And it hurts so much, so getting hit by that is just sadness, really. There's a bunch of really big fish in here. Don't really want to show it off too much, but just take my word for it. I'm just going to swim in here and see if they're all taken care of. It does look like it. And there's a bunch of armors in here. Like, there's just a bunch of health power-ups in this place, and it's very nice. Let's see. Oh, look at that one. That one's huge! And just looks so cool to see them all be all big and stuff. I don't know why, but I just really like resized enemies. If they look something like this. To just see like these gigantic beasts come towards you. I really love it. But yeah, that almost sums up this place. I guess there's a few more things. One is that if you grab these cannonballs, it spawns another two machine gunners, one over there and one all the way over here. And man, I'm not used to being completely out of sniper rifle bullets there, but we're just gonna have to manage. And for some reason, the fish, like one fish respawns in each basin after you walk all the way over there. And it's kind of annoying, but oh well. It's not really too much of a problem. I'm just gonna shoot them for the fun of it, because we don't really need anything else in these things. I might get the rockets, I guess. I don't know if I use those. Sometimes I like to be silly and just try to break all of the head statues and then fight all the biomechanoids, but it's kind of not very interesting to watch, really, because you just shoot ahead and then you hit it a bunch of times and then you shoot the next one, and yeah, you can actually destroy the heads with a cannonball, but the problem is you won't actually damage the guy inside it, so the only thing you'll do is waste cannonballs trying to kill them, and it's just kind of annoying, really. Now, there's two more things in this secret area. One is another secret cannon, so if you miss the first one, there is at least another one over here. Problem is, with a cannon, you only get one cannonball if you pick it up, which is kind of unfortunate, really. Most weapons, you just get about twice as much as an ammo box, but this one's an exception. And there's another 100 health power-up, which is cool, because it brings us to our maximum health and armor we can possibly carry. And that is the end of this secret area.